Well, it begins in South Carolina. And I chose South Carolina because there was still quite a heavy sense of racism in South Carolina at the time. And it really is the story of a burgeoning friendship between a white boy and a black boy at a time when white boys and black boys didn't really hang out with one another. These two individuals, Daniel and Nathan, grew up alongside one another, and then they're drafted to Vietnam, and they dodge the draft and go to Florida to escape having to go to Vietnam. And it really is their life story. It's the first 30 years of their life. It's told in flashback by Daniel, the white guy, who's on death row for killing Nathan, apparently. And he's visited every other day by a Catholic priest who is there to reconcile himself to the fact that, reconcile Daniel to the fact that he's going to be executed. There was a journalist from up in the north of France who I met when we released Sur le Silence many, many years ago, 2009, I think, who I'm still in communication with on a reasonably regular basis. And he was the guy that coined the phrase slow motion thriller, which I think is a good way of describing it, because you get time and space sufficient to discover the characters, but there still is that sense of urgency, that sense that time is going to run out, something's going to happen. Papillon de Nuit, which is called Candle Moth in England, which is just a made-up title, was the first book that was actually published by my British publisher. It was published in 2003, and it was actually the 23rd novel that I wrote. Prior to that, I'd enthusiastically collected rejection letters from publishers all over England and America, who routinely told me that the reason that they didn't want to publish me was because they didn't think that they could sell an American novel written by an Englishman. Anyway, I found a brave editor in 2002 who decided to take a gamble, and he bought Candle Moth for an extraordinarily small amount of money, but nevertheless, he did buy it. So that was my first publishing contract, and it was 15 years since I'd first put pen to paper. It was published in 2003. He took it to the Frankfurt Book Fair in the last part of 2002, sold it for translation into German, Italian, and Dutch. So it paid for itself in the UK before we'd even released it, which gave them adequate justification to give me a contract for the next two books. And the third one I wrote was Vendetta, which has already been translated into French. But it's an important book simply because it was the first one. What was the fundamental difference between that book and every book that I wrote prior? Very simply, I think with Papillon de Nuit, I wrote the book that I would like to read, as opposed to trying to write a book that I thought other people would like to read. I think that was the fundamental difference. I also tried to write as short a book as I could, and try and make it as succinct a story as I possibly could, and really concentrated on sort of trying to create an emotional effect with the characters.